Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Rokombo here at Mobile World Congress 2017, and this is actually a phone that was unveiled at CES 2017, but this is the first time we've actually been able to go hands-on with it. So this is the Asus Zenfone AR. So this phone is basically the second Project Tango capable phone on the market after the Lenovo Fab 2 Pro. Both phones are still finding their availability, but this one should be available around Q2 this year, maybe a little bit later. But I'm just going to take you through some of the hardware and software elements so you know what you can expect if you're really interested in Project Tango, which is Google's augmented reality hardware and software initiative. But I should also mention that this phone is also a Daydream capable, so it's one of the few Daydream capable phones out there as well. So if you've seen the Daydream view, or you've seen our coverage of the Google Pixel and Pixel XL, this phone might be a good alternative going forward. So what we're looking at here is a WQHD, I believe it's an IPS LCD, 5.7 inches, so it's a beautifully crisp, colorful screen running Zen UI atop Android 7.0 Android. So there is a pretty heavy skin on here. That means, you know, some of the navigation, the animations between the home screens here, there are a lot of Zen apps. Asus Zen Fit, for example, is built in there. And if I swipe down, the notifications pane and the search is all heavily skinned Android. So that is something you have to consider. If that's what you like, then great. If not, then maybe put a launcher on here if you want this kind of top tier hardware. Beneath the display as well, we have back and app switching capacitive keys and a physical home button, which is also a fingerprint sensor too, which is not all that surprising, but it is a slight difference to the likes of the Asus Zenfone 3, 3 Deluxe, that whole family, which use capacitive keys along the entire bottom. So there is that extra level of security on the front this time. Most of the other Zenfone 3 family handsets feature their fingerprint sensors on the back. Up the top, we have a, I believe it's an 8-megapixel front-facing camera. And as I turn it around, we have a metal build with metal hardware controls, nicely textured here, same kind of Zenfone aesthetic. The back is like a faux leather finish, and you can see the embossed Tango logo down here as well. Charges via Type-C USB, I should say too. And it supports quick charge 3.0 because it is powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 821 processor. Now, obviously, the camera technology is kind of a big deal. They call it the Asus Tri-Cam sensor, or system rather. So the main camera on the back is a 23 megapixel sensor. It offers up to 4K video recording. It features 4-axis optical image stabilization. It's a really solid sounding camera. 3x zoom as well, lossless zoom, I should say too. But you'll notice there's a secondary camera next to it, and then beneath that is a depth sensor. So you get laser autofocus, a tritone LED flash, or tri-LED flash, as they say, 23 megapixel main sensor, but then there's a secondary sensor and a depth sensor, which are used for the Project Tango based functionality. And Project Tango, basically, if you haven't seen it, is augmented reality, machine learning. It's a whole mix of technologies and disciplines. It basically gives you real-time room tracking and object tracking. So the examples that we've seen so far, which this phone doesn't actually have any experience with, so I can't show you right now, but trust me when I say that, yeah, Project Tango is an interesting new technology that you'll see more of as time goes on. And it basically allows you to scan a room and you can do things like put a car in there. So BMW have an iDiscover experience where you can put in their i3 or their i8 in real size. You can even open the doors, you can move around the car as you step around your room, and you can walk right up to it. So it's sort of like HoloLens-like augmented reality, but through the guise of a smartphone. The thing to really note about this is that Asus has managed to slim this phone down to a standard smartphone footprint and size. It doesn't look big, it doesn't feel bulky, and that's really impressive considering the first Project Tango device, the Lenovo Fab 2 Pro, is a huge phone. It has a much bigger camera arrangement and sensor arrangement. It's a 6.4-inch display. It's absolutely massive. So this means that Project Tango going forward could be really, really prevalent because of phones like this. Now, there's a couple of other things to mention. This thing features a 3,300 milliamp battery, which should last you through a day without any issues. I say a day because of that high resolution screen, because of the AR and VR tech available here. You'll probably run it down quite quickly. And the other thing to note is the amount of RAM available. So depending on the market, you get either 6 gigabytes or 8 gigabytes of RAM, which I think is the highest amount of RAM I've seen in any smartphone ever, basically. 8 gigabytes of RAM should ensure that this phone is blisteringly fast, whether it's doing AR or VR, which of course are the most intensive tasks processing graphically that you can kind of put through a smartphone right now in 2017. On top of that, you get 128 gigabytes of storage or 256 gigabytes, depending again on the market. And there's also micro SD expandability by a further 256 gigabytes. So that's a really impressive setup here. Obviously, the last thing to note is price. There isn't an official exact price yet, and there's no confirmation as to whether it's coming to the likes of the UK. But this phone should be available for around 800 euros. So it's not cheap, but that's kind of what you pay for the latest technology, cutting edge stuff like Project Tango. So that is an overview of the Asus Zenfone AR. It's a really impressive looking device on these first impressions. If you have any questions about this device, just drop us a line down below in the comments. And you can read more on recombi.com/mobile. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel, and thanks for watching.